Hey guys, and welcome back to Dragon's Dogma. So last episode we just defeated the... It's still here. Is it fully... It looks like it's not actually decaying. Well, this is the Beholder, or whatever it's called in this game. It's called the Beholder in D&D at least. We took it down eventually. It gave us 3 wake stones for us to continue with. This will not open. Looks like the connecting doors are all closed. Almost as if there was multiple ways to get here or something. I think that was the only way to go, so either the doors back there are gonna be open, or we're gonna be able to... Maybe we'll just be jumping down to another ledge? That reminds me. I should be checking my equipment, because we got some stuff from the boss fight and I forgot to look at it right away. Oh my goodness. So these weapons are powerful. An exquisite longbow worthy of its namesake, it flies arrows infused with draconic power. Apparently it has the same strength as the, it's just an all-around more powerful bow. These are more powerful daggers. And they look crazy too. Kind of nullifies all the upgrades we got for the other ones a little bit, but okay. I'll be sure to equip these. Draconic power should be effective. We got the Dragon's Bond. Bonus to strength and magic, loss of 1 defense. Possesses the wisdom of the dragon. Okay. There's something crazy looking. I just got spikes on my forehead now. Whoa, 100% resistance to something? No. Oh, that's just my... It gives me 10% and I just have 100% overall, it looks like. Alright. Difference in visual for sure. We'll get to see my character's face more, I guess. Dragon hide does not seem to be an upgrade at the moment. Fitting appearance, though. I keep insisting on using the lion's spine. I think it's the only DLC item I'm using on my character. I just like the asymmetrical appearance of it. Otherwise, I've avoided them. It's fashion's dogma, you know? Get to remember what our character looks like. Any updates? Are the same stuff as before?
'Tis a chilling sight, watching the cadavers fall ever down the shaft. It sets this pawn's body to trembling.
You guys have emotions? You can get nervous about something? I don't think there's anywhere else to go around here. This map's not very useful because it's localized to this individual loaded region. I'll save first, but I think I'm supposed to just jump back off the cliff and land on another ledge, basically. Could be right, could be wrong. It'll be interesting. Yep, leap into the Everfall to explore the next area. Okay. Not a turn I expected this game to take, especially with how many times I've died from falling before. Ow. I live here now. Pain. Press R2 at the right, at just the right time to grab on. Hello.
Hello.
You're just some pawn. I thought you were gonna be a certain witch character. Yes, though. While you can heal me.
I shall restore your health.
There you go. You feel needed now. Congratulations. The Chamber of Oh. Okay. Did not expect that. I'm like, oh, let's meet the local pawns here that are happy to see me. It's like, nope, Chamber of Death.
The sight of women excited.
Apparently. Oh no. That was a timely catch on that guy's part. Everyone gets startled now. Well, that's the explodey one, watch out. Should be all down now. Ooh, ow. Monkey ass got angry. Oh, there's 2 of them. Oh. Did not account for the idea of there being 2 of them. Hello, friend. Just gonna put some holes in you real quick. Hey, hey. Rude. How did I get over here? Where am I? Where am I right now? Oh, I'm on his arm. Okay. This is a weird moment for me. I'll keep going, though. Okay. Just keep hacking away! Headshot! Okay, I'm a little hard, a little disoriented. Keep going. Take one down and then we'll have one less issue to deal with. There we go. There we go. Nip this in the bud before it got too complicated. There's more wake stones. There are more wake stones, alright. Thought they'd be a little harder to get, honestly. Oh god. Goodness me. $5,000 experience. Alright. More wake stones just everywhere. Holy crap. This is going to be briefer than I originally thought, perhaps. 5 out of 20. The shards certainly help. We got two shards and two wake stones out of that. So almost 3 full wake stones again. Certainly a little easier than the beholder was. Grab a few things. Here we go. Rusted plate. Good to go, I think. Yeah. Should have quick saved. Alright, well, that happened. Stop that. I just like having that option. Are they all dead? Oh, they're all dead. Wow. That was effective. He's gonna explode. Don't stand by him. Botticelli. Come on, man. He seems friendly. A little too friendly, honestly. Like certain berserk monsters you don't want to be around. Oh, no, no. Down with you. Headshots. Keep working on him. Oh god, Hellowit. No! Good thinking, Hell, but a little warning. Alright, let's do that too. Alright, he kind of dodged that. Alright, well, I guess I was doing did everything that I told Hell not to do. Hey, friend. He seems happy to be here. Fall over. Fall over! Come on. A little longer. Look at that wibbly wobbly leg. There we go. We've already gained 3 levels since the new expansion. The post game. The new expansion. We're up to 7 wake stones. Shards are another component of this situation. Poor Botticelli. Here, I'll help you, Botticelli. There. Feel better? It's really amusing being able to do that. And abusive. He's been in my party for a while now. TLE is going to have a lot of rift points to come at him once I send him back. Which will probably be sooner, because I think I've passed him in level now, but TLE has probably played further than that. For those who don't know, basically none of you, I used to play some games along with Wanderbot with someone that had the username TLE on the internet, and this is their pawn. I didn't know that for a long time. I was just running around with Botticelli because they were a big useful tank character that wasn't stupidly designed like half the people I had access to. Howdy, folks. You seem friendly. Yeah, that dazzle combo's really nice. Just stagger absolutely everybody. To be fair, they're just undead, so they're probably not hard to begin with, but it's funny to me to do that. Frigid finger. Giant coin pouch. Let's see, when these videos are going up, definitely give me an idea of how many bosses there are around here. I might look up how many bosses there are. With the amount of wake stones they're giving me, I'm getting the feeling you might be able to finish this area before finishing all the bosses. And I'd prefer to go to find all the bosses first. Is this gonna be one? Please? Yeah, I'm saving over the saving that's saving over the save. Double the saves, double the power. Oh, you look nasty. Hey, friend. Is it a cockatrice, I think? Yep, that's a cockatrice. Alright, we're having our second version of this guy. Saurians! None of that right now, okay? None of that. is making less than encouraging sounds that made it sound like I wasn't hurting him, but I was definitely hurting him. Uh-oh. Oh, that's not good. Botticelli, no! Petrification cannot be cured by normal magic. It is fatal if left untreated. The secret, use secret softener or the like to cure any petrified allies. Am I petrified? I'm gonna die? So without softener, I'm gonna die. Well, crap. We haven't really been introduced to that one yet. Do I have a softener? Cures most physical debilitations. Intervenite. I have a bunch of those. I have a bunch of softener, I think, too. I just haven't been carrying them around. Let's see. Raise defense. So many items around here. Boost magic. Boost strength. Magic defense. Well, we're in trouble here. Can I heal myself with items, too? Oh, I can still heal myself with items, huh? Alright. Maybe I'll... I think the Interventive. I think that would heal it, but I think I should probably finish the fight first if I can. Is he invincible right now? Stop doing that. Oh wow, my whole character moves in slow-mo in this form. That is rough. Alright, well I'll have to cure it then. I'm good now? I am not good. That is not what that item does. Well, today we learned that this is a thing in this game. Oh, did I die? I think I went full statue. Okay. That was extreme. Now I'm not gonna use a wake stone, I have a save. Alright, maybe we'll go visit a store for some softeners. Increases the potency of curatives you use. Causes your arrows to fly farther. Increases cumulative damage with foes you debilitate with non-magic attacks. Maybe not that one. Definitely a tenfold arrow. Upgrade to sixfold arrow, definitely. Upgrade to body binder, even though I haven't been using that one. Whirlwind arrow is an AoE attack. It's also cheap. Definitely getting upgrades here. Morbidity. Yeah, that's the one. Yeah, let's just grab it. They give me the options. And down we go once again. Good news is I'm repaired. Bad news is, don't necessarily know how to find where I was before. So, I got some equipment to help with softening. Yeah, this is not the right ledge, is it? Maybe I should just intentionally fall off. Maybe I'll find the right one. Yay! It was under another ledge, right? Oh man. This is gonna be hard to judge. You can see my health bars of my teammates way down there. The loop! Yeah, where did I fall? Ow. I don't think this is it either, is it? Probably not. The place is so nondescript overall, it could practically be anywhere, really. It could be that one. Not that I'm gonna land over there right now. Ow. I ended up right back where I was a second ago, didn't I? Yep. So we got two new, pawns, by the way. So there's that at least. I went back to Sorcerer and Mage. I'm just gonna go this way. We'll find my way back to the other ledge on accident at some point. Sorry to give you the tease of that boss fight, but hey, I lost. Chamber of Tragedy. What's this one gonna be? Is it gonna be tragic? What do we have here? Oh, harpies. Oh, rude. Come here. You live here now, on the ground. It's your new home. Enjoy. No more singing. Stop it. Stop it. No more singing. None of that. Is that a wisp over there? Ooh. explosions everywhere. If that's the wispy type enemy that I think it is, then it's a good thing I brought a caster in. Brought a sorcerer back for the first time in a while. It's actually out-leveled Botticelli. His owner apparently must have stopped playing. Oh, it's dead already? Out of the sky. Oh! Alright. Flying enemies becoming at you. Oh. That was funny. Down with you. Oh, jeez. We're having troubles here. Is that Lynette fighting us? Is that why I'm taking so much damage? Have they been fully possessed against us? Drink some spring water. I will slice the crap out of you if you don't stop. You're mine now. No more possession. Stop it. Guys, kill it. Kill its face off. You can do it. I got Lynette. We don't have to worry about that anymore. Well, now who's possessed? Did we get it? We safe now? Is she still going to be attacking me? Take it out. There are enough harpies around here. Oh, no. Okay, not a fan of this location. It's getting a little bitey. Jeez. Probably not the most effective strategy against these guys. There we go. And just hack away. No, you knocked it out of my range. Stop it. There we go. There we go. Oh, no. Down with you. Oh, no. They're grabby. Stay down. Stay down. Stay down. No more flying. Come on. Alright, we should be good now. Hey, stop it. There's still more of you? I thought those were the last ones. Crap. There we go. There we go, done with that nonsense. No, we're not. Holy crap. Welcome to the land of infinite harpies. Fuck you, Harpy. There we go. How many? How? How are there still more? There we go. Each one's worth a half a thousand. Strength in numbers, Arisen. Each one is worth a half a thousand. Alright, what a mess. Healing up, though. What you guys got over here? Just a wall? Can I climb up to something? Nope, can't walk on that. Can't jump that high. Oh, hey. Well, until I saw the statues, I was gonna say it reminds me of the cave. The certain vertical cavern we all, a lot of us will remember from Until Dawn. That goes up, this goes out. Multiple directions. Oh, that's a new one. Where is it? Alright. That changed things up a little bit. Surprise gargoyle now. I'm trying. You grabbed him behind me. There we go. Pro tip hell, if you're gonna do that, don't pull him out of my current combo. Silly. Salome's secret. Is there a light over here? Oh. I'm expecting a lot of gargoyles here. You're mine, gargoyle. I meant to do... That works too. That's what I meant to do the first time. Take that. No. Oh well. What if I just keep throwing it? Yay. Oopsie. There we go. He's down. There we go. Tenfold arrow. It's a lot of arrows. They're still dropping wakestone pieces. That'll make us some progress. What do we got around here? Ooh. What do you have? Another shard? And a diadem. I believe that is a helm. And I believe that does not open. Same. Oh, can't be used. It's a casting item. Alrighty then. Fine. I like being rejected. Helps me live the thrill. Alright, so this is all a dead end. So let's check the staircase we saw in the other direction. Looks like that must be what was up there. Yay, dungeons! Usually I complain about extensive dungeon crawls, but the dungeons actually always feel really good in this game, and they're paced really well. So I don't really mind if the rest of the game even is just a dungeon. Because the story's kind of, it exists. This is its primary characteristic. the biggest development about the story so far is this crazy thing that happens after you defeat the dragon. Aside from that, the most interesting thing since then was probably the original point where he rips out my heart and turns me into an immortal undead in the first place. Longer chamber here. There's a gate here. No access, just a creepy gargoyle. Wakestone shard. That just became a wakestone. Go ahead and pass that over. Enjoy that hell. So now we should have 8 or 9. 9. We have half our wakestones, and it's like episode 2 of being down here. Say, softener. I'll take all that I can get for our next encounter with that boss. So we just don't have access to here? There's like a switch? That's a drop down. If you guys want, feel free to tell me how many bosses are down here. Like, you don't have to spoil what they are at all, but just be like, there's 5 or something, and then I'll have an idea whether I should be continuing or not yet. Because I would like to fight them all. Dark Souls style and all that. Is there nowhere to go up here? I think that's it. I think that's all we're getting from around here, unless I'm making a terrible mistake. But the gates don't seem to open. Still, we've still probably got like 2 or 3 Wakestone shards around here, so it was a worthwhile expedition. Even with all the nasty possessions happening. Back yonder to main world. Maybe I'll accidentally drop back onto the starting zone. Oop, does this lead somewhere? Like in Demon Souls? Doesn't look like it. Part of me is definitely a little bit afraid that maybe as we go around this area, I'll fall into a pattern of jumping from ledge to ledge that doesn't lead to discovering new places enough. That place looks cool. Let's go over there. Hey! Ow! My face. I wonder if the ledge grabbing mechanic means I don't take damage that way.
I shall restore your health.
Healing! Alright, so where do you head to? The Chamber of Lament. Y'all ready to lament a thing or two? Oh geez, this is a big one. And it's very lamenty. This looks like a place where I'm gonna fight a dragon. Am I gonna fight a dragon? Seems like I'm gonna fight a dragon. It's a huge area to fight. I mean, it looks big enough to redo the original final boss fight. Or whatever you want to call it. Am I gonna become an Arisen again? Yeah, this has all the shape that I'd expect from a dragon fight area. Purple stuff's freaky looking. Hello, money. Yummy, yummy. Cool, a fire pit. Things have really evolved since back when I was in college. Alright, purple fire, how you doing? Hi. Are we fighting?
I will protect you, Arisen.
Yep. Wow, we are actually fighting other people's pawns.
Now we'll gain the upper hand.
Okay, they're not that strong though. Bye. Don't throw my characters off the cliff. Shame on you.
We have triumphed. Lucky is the pawn able to fight.
They tried to grab my character and throw them off the cliff. Wow, that was a Dark Souls moment. They actually summoned. They summoned.
Then you have come. Very well, Arisen.
Hi. Am I fighting him again? Sure seems like the same guy. Is this the undead version of him? Oh my goodness. Ur-Dragon Generation 46. He's hurt, though. The Ur-Dragon is an incredibly powerful foe. Defeating it requires multiple encounters, chipping more of its health away each time. What? That's some craziness. Alright, what's over here? When you're connected online, other players' progress will contribute to the defeating their dragon in your instance. The reward you earn depends on how much you dish out. You're really lucky you can even deliver the final blow. Ow! That's an interesting mechanic there. What is this? Hunters of the Ur-Dragon. Are these the last 45 people? Or, no. Are these all the people that previously attacked him? Two of these people are infinite level? What's this? Oh, that's how you leave. Those are some big spells happening over there. Hell, get back up. Oh, jeez. I almost died just then. Okay, this is not what I expected today to have happen, isn't it? Let's just chomp on some grass. And let's just go show them what's what. Come here, Drac. He left? That was abrupt. Well, this was a strange encounter. So there's a magical dragon that jumps from game to game attacking players, and you get a reward based on how much you hurt it, basically? And I assume you're supposed to keep coming back to this specific chamber to keep fighting him. What a weird mechanic. It's almost like having a Dark Souls invader, like any of the Dark Souls invaders, but then those invaders are like super hard to fight, and they're like a Diablo 2 hardcore character where they go from game to game, but someone eventually can permanently kill them. Although I assume he just comes back, of course. But I mean, like that sort of chipping away concept. This was weird. Maybe if you get the killing blow, you get some more wake stones. That was an encounter. That's all we get from you? Alright. That's all we're getting from that. Alright, today's been a weird episode of non-starters, hasn't it? Getting introduced to fights, and then getting defeated by them, or having them run away from me. Going over here now! Ooh, ledge. Ow. That hurt. Have I been to you already? The Chamber of Fate. They're just vague enough of names that they're gonna be hard to remember. We fought I think the behemoth was the Chamber of Confusion? So maybe... Oh my god, this dragon. We're fighting a dragon now. Alright, in a world where the game is 90% boss fights. Ow. Oh, I'm getting chewed on. Don't appreciate that. Yes, I would appreciate that. Oh no. It's gonna be hard staying on the healing radius when she tries to heal me. Oh, is that the heal? Oh, that was nowhere near me. Going for it. Watch out. Whew.
Help me.
This is my chance. Heart shot. Yeah, it does. Oh, he seems angry about something. Goddamn harpies. Calm your shit. That was the, I don't really know how that shot works, the whirling arrow. It's supposed to make rain. I thought it might have been the raining arrows thing or something. Maybe not. You need to calm down with your wings. Let's work on these harpies. Nope, missed. That's fine, his heart's open. Oh, shit! Rude. Ooh. Hey, Durgan. There we go. You feeling good? Where am I? That's a lot of ice. Take out all the chunks. Come on. Oh, that's not good. Come on. Oh, that was a bad aim. There we go. Just get right up in there. Oh, back up. It definitely got easier to kill. That was a bit of a miss. Try that again. Oh. He's going down again. We got it. Get out of the way. Another 22,000 experience right there. The seat of God lies below, beyond. Getting our wake stones.
How many of these wake stone shards do we require?
20. 20. So, and then I need to find out where to put them. But 20. There's one. How many did we just get? We're up to 12 already, wow. Alright. Ugh, I think that's climactic enough of a place to end the episode, guys. Thanks for watching like always, and I'll see you next time. There, finally a satisfying boss skill after two non-starters.